Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
Hello everybody, today we are going to start with Merchant of Venice, Act 2, Scene 7. In the last class, we completed Scene 6 and there was a question for you all that Portia lives in which place, Belmont or Venice. So, somebody with the name Hope Hope, I do not know the actual name of this person. If you want a shout out of your name, if you want your name to be called out in the next video, if you want to answer the question and you want it to be called out in the next video, you do write your actual name under the comment you have made. Okay, so that I can call out your name. I'm very happy to call the name out over here. Although I do not know the real name, it is Hope Hope, something like that. So you have answered it correctly. And for today, we will also have a question that you will answer. I know you all are very excited for that. And the question will not be in the first part, but the question will be put in the last part of the class, because the question is from Act 2, Scene 7 itself. If you listen to it properly, if you listen to it attentively, you will be able to answer, I am very sure. Okay, so let's see how much you are able to understand the video, and let's see who can answer the question at the end of the scene. Okay, let's move to the scene now. The Merchant of Venice, Act 2, Scene 7. We are again in Belmont, which is the place where Portia stays. It is a room in Portia's house. Flourish of cornets. That means, what is a cornet? Cornet is a type of instrument. These are instruments which is played when a king enters or when an important personality is coming inside. This instrument is played. Enter Portia with the Prince of Morocco. We are already aware of this name. Who is Prince of Morocco? Prince of Morocco is that person who has come from Africa, who has come from a place which is very hot, and therefore his skin complexion is dark. So Prince of Morocco has come and all his men has also come over here. Portia, go draw aside the curtains and discover. That means move the curtains aside. You see this picture, you have to move. Portia orders her people to remove the curtains or move aside the curtains so that the caskets which are present behind the curtains, they could be seen. There are the caskets over here and the curtain is removed so that Morocco can see these caskets. What are caskets now? Let us see. Caskets are kind of boxes. You see this one? This is the casket. This is a box. And now make your choice. So now he can see the caskets and now Portia tells Morocco to choose. The first of gold. Now Morocco sees the caskets. How does these caskets look? One is made out of gold, one is made of silver, and another one is of lead. So the first gold one had an inscription. What is an inscription? Inscription is certain written lines on top of this box. There are certain lines which is written on top of the box. He has to read the lines and understand the meaning of it and then choose accordingly. So what is written on top of the gold casket? Who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire. So what is written over there? It is written that whoever chooses me shall gain or shall get what many people desire or many people want. So whoever is going to choose me shall get what many people want. Okay. Now comes the silver casket. What is written on top of it? Who chooseth me shall get as much as he deserves. So the person who chooses me, that is the person who chooses a silver casket, will get whatever he deserves. So if I have studied well and if I have prepared for my examination well, then I deserve to be first in class. So whoever chooses me will get whatever he deserves. Now we will come to the third one. The third one is dull lead. It is a lead casket. With warning all as blunt. So what is written on top of it? It is a warning. Who chooseth me, that means whoever chooses me, must give and hazard all he hath. Now it hath means has. So whoever is going to choose me has to give, has to hazard. That means has to risk everything. Whatever he has to risk it if he has to choose me. How shall I know if I do choose the right? Now Morocco asks Portia that how will I understand whether I have chosen the correct casket or not? Portia, the one of them contains my picture. So among these three, one casket, the box. Inside the box, my picture is there. So if you can identify or if you can understand or correctly pick that in which box my picture is there, then I am yours, Vithal. That means I will totally be yours. I will be marrying you, Morocco. Some God direct my judgment. So Morocco says, may God be with me. Let me see. So let me see what is written in the casket. I will survey. That means I will again read the inscriptions back again. Again, I will read the inscriptions. What says this leaden casket? So he starts with the lead casket. Lead casket. Who chooseth me must give an hazard all he hath. These lines, you do one thing, you memorize these. Questions can come from here that what was written on top of the lead casket, what was written on top of the gold casket. Okay, then you have to write this line. So, must give for what? For lead. Hazard for lead. This casket threatens. So, lead has a very dull color. You can see over here, na? It is a very dull color. So, Morocco is a person who measures everything in terms of money. Okay, he has come here to marry somebody that is not related to money. If you are in love with somebody, you do not see that this person has a lot of money, so I will marry her. No, that is not done. So Morocco's mentality is something like that. Morocco is measuring everything in terms of money. So he sees this lead casket and says that this is so dull, this is cheap, this is not at all costly, then this casket is threatening. Why should I choose lead casket? Men that hazard all do in hope of fair advantages. That means whenever you are risking something, what is written on the lead casket? That you have to risk everything you have. So he says that I should not risk for lead, because whenever we are risking money or whenever we are risking something, we do it for profit. Who says like this? Who thinks like this? A businessman, that if I am giving 10 rupees, I am hoping that I will profit from here. So he completely thinks like a businessman. He thinks that if I cannot do profit from it, why should I choose it? So why should I risk anything for lead, which is so dull and cheap? A golden mind stoops not to the show of dross. So golden mind, whose golden mind? Morocco's golden mind. He feels that I have a very intelligent mind. I am so intelligent. I am so noble. Why should I choose shows of dross? That means why should I choose such a worthless thing as lead? I will then nor give nor hazard aught for lead. So I will not give or risk anything for lead. So he decides he will not choose the lead casket. What is the important question that can come from here? Why did Morocco not choose the lead casket? What would be your answer? The answer would be that Morocco had a very measured everything in terms of money. He thought that lead is so cheap, so dull, so he is not going to risk anything for lead. Okay. Who says the silver, what says the silver with her virgin hue? See, the silver metal has a very whitish color. I think you all have silver jewelry in your house or silver material. You must have seen it. It has a whitish color. So, now he moves on to the silver casket. He has decided that no, I am not going to choose the lead casket. He moves to the silver casket. Who chooseth me shall get as much as he deserves. So he reads the line over there that whoever chooses me shall get as much as he deserves. As much as he deserves. Pause there, Morocco, and weigh thy value with an even hand. So now Morocco tells himself that let me measure impartially whether I deserve Portia or not. This is a weighing scale. I think everybody knows this. You measure the weight of certain things. So at one side he puts himself and on the other side he puts Portia. He tries to see whether they deserve each other or not, whether Morocco deserves Portia or not. If thou beest rated, he talks about himself only. Beest rated means if I judge myself by my estimation, by my qualities, if I judge myself that what I am, what are my qualities, if I deserve Portia or not, then I can understand that I deserve enough. Okay, that I deserve enough. I obviously deserve Portia. I have so many good qualities. I do deserve Portia. And yet enough may not extend so far as to the lady. But again, he thinks that Portia is so beautiful, so wealthy, she is so good in everything. Do I actually deserve her? He doubts himself. And immediately, you know that he is very proud of himself. Immediately, what does he say? yet to be afeard of my deserving were but a weak disabling of myself. He says that, but by thinking that I don't deserve Portia is discrediting myself, is something which is, if I think like that, then it would be demeaning myself. I obviously am equal to Portia. Why should I think that I am not equal to her? As much as I deserve. Why, that's the lady. Yes, I do deserve the lady. I'm as good as her. So what are the reasons for which he deserves Portia? In birth, that means he is of noble birth. He's a noble man. And in fortunes, that means he is wealthy also, just like Portia. In graces, that means in good qualities, in virtues. In that way also, Portia's qualities are equal to Morocco's. And in qualities of breeding, that means he has a good upbringing, he has been educated well, and therefore, in that respect also, he deserves Portia. So these are the four reasons. But more than these, in love, I do deserve. Most importantly, I deserve her because I truly love her. Nobody else loves her so much as I do. What if I strayed no further? Now he feels that what if I thought no further and directly chose the silver casket? But chose here means I directly chose the silver casket without thinking any further. But then he is confused. He thinks that let me see once more what is written on the golden casket. Let's see once more this saying graved in gold. Who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire. So he thinks that, okay, let me read the golden casket's inscriptions once more. And why that is the lady? What is written on the golden casket? That many men desire, and whatever that many men desire, you are going to get. Now he starts thinking. Many men do desire the lady. Many people desire her. And all the world desires her. The whole world desires Portia, wants to get Portia, wants to marry Portia. From the four corners of the earth they come. So all these people are coming from various parts of the world. Why? Just with an intention, just with a desire to marry Portia. To kiss this shrine. Now this is a metaphor. He compares two things. Shrine is a religious place where a holy person lives. Okay. So which one is the shrine over here? The shrine is Belmont, is the house of Portia in Belmont. That is the shrine, that is the religious place. And who is the saint in this shrine? Who is the religious person in this shrine, in this religious place? That one is Portia. So just imagine the comparison. Portia is compared to a saint. As people visit religious places, as people go for pilgrimage, isn't it? We go to, the Hindus go to the various temples, and the Muslims go to mosques, and there are so many people going to so many religious places, isn't it? So similar to that, people are from various corners of the world are coming and visiting Belmont. Why? Because they have an intention of marrying Portia, who is just like a saint. The Hyrcanian deserts and the vasty wilds of wide Arabia are as thoroughfares. So they can cross deserts, they can cross the wilderness, they can cross the Arabian Sea, just like they are crossing the main roads. As you cross the main road, it is quite similar to that to them. They easily cross these difficult places and come. Why? Just because they are very excited in marrying Portia. For princes to come view fair Portia. So they are coming from very, very far away. They are coming crossing deserts and seas, and they're crossing dangerous places just like anything, and coming here, taking so much risks just to marry Portia. The watery kingdom, that means the dangerous sea, whose ambitious head spits in the face of heaven. Now you will see this picture. This will make it easier for you. See, this is the sea. And when there is a storm on the sea, what happens is these waves become very high. Okay. And it seems that they are touching the sky. Obviously, you know, when there is a storm, the waves become so huge, it seems that they spit in the face of heaven. That means it seems that the waves are touching the sky. Is no bar to stop the foreign spirits. But although there are storms in the sea, there are so many troubles in crossing the dangerous sea, they are not afraid. These ships still come out to visit Belmont just to try their luck if they can marry Portia or not. As over a brook, they cross the dangerous sea as if they are crossing a small stream. Why they are taking so much of risk? Just to see fair Portia. Okay. One of these three contains her heavenly picture. So one of these three caskets obviously has the heavenly picture of Portia. Is it like that lid contains her? Now he thinks, should I choose the lid casket? Will it have the picture of Portia? It were damnation to think so base a thought. No, I should not think so cheap a thought. How can Portia's picture, who is such a jewel, be in such a base metal? Portia and the lid casket are completely different. One is very costly and this lid is so cheap. So Portia's picture cannot be in the lid casket. To rib her sear cloth. What is a sear cloth? Sear cloth is the cloth which you use to cover a dead body. So not even a sear cloth would be inside this obscure grave, would not be inside this dark lid casket. Nothing can be inside this, not even the cloth to cover the dead body. Or shall I think in silver she is immured? So he starts thinking, should I think that she is there locked up inside the silver casket? Being 10 times undervalued to tried gold. Now, question, why didn't he choose the silver casket? He gives a number of reasons why he should choose the silver casket. Now he is giving one reason why he should not choose that. What is that? It is this, he has measured all the three casket in terms of money. So lead is cheaper than silver and gold. Silver is cheaper than gold. Gold is the costliest over here. So obviously in the presence of gold, silver is cheaper than that, isn't it? So when gold is here, why should I choose a cheaper metal? It is good to choose gold only when it is there, because he is thinking in terms of money. Okay. Oh, sinful thought, never so rich a gem was set in worse than gold. So he starts thinking that when gold is there, which is the costliest of all, it is better to choose gold, because Portia is the costliest of all women. They have in England a coin that bears the figure of an angel. He says that this is the picture of that coin. You see, this is a gold coin and it has the stamp of an angel over it. Okay. So he says that there is a coin which has an angel's stamp on it. Okay. But that's inscribed upon. That means the image of this angel is stamped on the coin. But here an angel in a golden bed lies all within. So on this coin, the figure of the angel is stamped. It is on top of it. And over here, what we will find inside the gold casket, we have the picture of the angel. Okay, that is the picture of Portia. Deliver me the key. That means give me the key. Here do I choose. So I am choosing the gold casket. And thrive I as I may. May I succeed. I wish I will succeed. Portia. There, take it, prince. And if my form lie there, that means if my picture is inside this gold casket, then I'm yours, then I'm going to marry you. He unlocks the golden casket. Now he opens the gold casket. Morocco. Oh hell, what have we here? My goodness, what is here? A carrion death. That means this is a skull. He finds a skull inside the gold casket. And inside these sockets, you know, these are the eye sockets. Inside this socket, there is a scroll. What is the scroll? Scroll is a piece of paper which you can roll up like this one. I will read the writing. So let me read what is written on this scroll. What is written on the scroll? Very important question. Remember whatever is written over it. All that glitters is not gold. Often have you heard that told. So you must have heard this line. We all have heard this line. That everything that shines may not be as costly as it seems. May not be good. Whatever shines may not be good every time. You go to the market, you find a very shiny apple, you bring it because you thought that this must be the best one. When you come home and you bite the apple, you find that there is a worm inside it. Okay, so you understand that whatever looks shiny may not be good. That is written in the scroll. What else is written? Many a man his life hath sold, but my outside to behold. So there are many foolish people who have just seen the outside and chosen me and became fools. Now, he gives one example also. It is written inside the scroll. Gilded tombs to worms enfold. If you go to Egypt, you will find pyramids and inside there are these tombs which is made out of gold. Okay, however, what is inside? The dead body is inside. And what is decomposing the dead body? The worms only. So, although the tomb is made out of gold, although the tomb is gold plated, inside, what is there? The dead body is inside. And the dead body is being eaten up by those worms that decompose your body. Okay. So, you need to understand what lies within. You cannot choose by looking at the outside. Okay, this one looks so beautiful. This must be a very good woman or this must be a very good man. You cannot choose like that. You have to understand what's within. Had you been as wise as bold, that means if you would have been clever as you chose so boldly as you immediately thought that, okay, I will choose this gold casket. If you would have thought deeper, if you have spent more time in thinking wisely, young in limbs, in judgment old, if you would have been more experienced as you are young and you are more, if you would have been more experienced, your answer had not been enscrolled. That means if you had been more experienced, if you would have been more wise, then you would not have chosen the gold casket. And you would not have seen this scroll. Fare you well. Okay, then goodbye. Goodbye. Now, this part is the end of the letter. Okay, the scroll. Whatever is written in the scroll is written. So, fare you well. Your suit is cold. So, obviously, your hopes are all dead. Now, you will have to go back home and you will never be given to marry. You know, na, that was the clause that if you choose incorrectly, you will not marry anybody henceforth. Cold indeed and labors lost. So now Morocco has understood already that he has lost his chance and so he accepts it. Cold indeed and labor lost. That means I have tried but I have failed. Then farewell heat and welcome frost. Okay, then goodbye heat. That means goodbye love. And what will I welcome? I will welcome frost, which is sadness, depression, that I could not choose the correct casket. And therefore, I will not be able to marry Portia. Portia, adieu. That means Portia, goodbye. I have too grieved a heart. I am very sad today. I have a very sad heart. And I therefore cannot take a tedious leave. I cannot take a formal leave. Thus, losers part. And in this way, when you lose the competition, when you lose the game, then you hide your face and run away. In the same manner, I will also run away from here. I am very ashamed of myself, of my stupidity. Exit with his train, so he goes away. Flourish of cornets. Now, I have set this picture just to explain you one thing, that why couldn't Morocco choose the correct casket? Only because of this, that he had measured everything in terms of money. So, because gold was the costliest of all, he had chosen it instead of silver, instead of lead. Okay? So, the important questions that can be said from here is, what were the reasons for which he did not choose the lead casket? Why did he choose the gold casket? Why did he first think that he would choose the silver casket? And why did he finally not choose the silver casket? These would be the questions. Portia, a gentle riddance. So, Portia is not interested in anybody other than the person whom she loves. So, she is constantly expecting that everybody should fail other than that person whom she loves. Okay, so gentle riddance. He is very happy that finally this person has gone. Draw the curtains. That means again, draw the curtains over the casket so that nobody else can see it. Let all of his complexion, that means let all the people who has his skin color or who has similar qualities or those people who are foolish like him, choose me so. Makes the wrong choice. And therefore, I will not have to marry these people. I am not interested in marrying any of them. So, I wish they choose the incorrect casket. Exit. So, from this part of the chapter, I have already told you in the beginning that the question will be set from scene 7. And I will ask you in the last part of the last, when I have completed explaining you the chapter. Let's see who has understood this best. The question for you is, why did Morocco not choose the silver casket? Why did Morocco not choose the silver casket? This is number 1. And number two, the easiest of all, what were the three caskets? What were the three caskets? That means, what were the three caskets placed over there? And what were the inscriptions on those caskets? Okay, you write it down. And if you are writing it down, if you want your name to be shouted out in the second, in the next video that I make, you obviously write down your name, okay? Because your YouTube names are sometimes not that clear. So you write down your name below the comment so that I can also call your name while I say who has answered it correctly and fast. Okay, so thank you. I hope you have liked the video. If you have liked it, you press the like button and also comment and subscribe.